Good morning. Question, when will we repent? Today we're at Jeremiah chapter 6, verses 21 to 26. Therefore, thus says the Lord, behold, I will lay stumbling blocks before this people, and the fathers and the sons together shall fall on them. The neighbor and his friend shall perish. Thus says the Lord, behold, a people comes from the north country, and a great nation will be raised from the farthest parts of the earth. They will lay hold on bow and spear. They are cruel and have no mercy. Their voice roars like the sea, and they ride on horses as men of war, set in array against you, O daughter of Zion. We have heard the report of it. Our hands grow feeble. Anguish has taken hold of us. Pain is of a woman in labor. Do not go out into the field, nor walk by the way, because of the sword of the enemy. Fear is on every side, O daughter of my people. Dress in sackcloth and roll about in ashes. Make mourning as for an only son, most bitter lamentation, for the plunderer will suddenly come upon us. The prophetic warnings to the kingdom of Judah have been mounting, mounting, mounting. The people ignored them, but now word has come. The invaders are marching toward Jerusalem. The wake-up call has at last gone out, and at last maybe some will be ready to wake up. And the prophet has instructions. Dress in sackcloth, roll about in ashes, and make mourning. There is one thing left that the people of God can now do. They can repent. They can mourn, repent, and trust in God. But will they do it? Love is not perfected in fear, and yet fear is one of the pieces in God's toolbox. And when he can't use the best motivations, sometimes he'll use other motivations if they help his people move toward his purpose for them. So yes, fear is a legitimate motivation. It's just not the best one. God wants us to move toward a place where he can work with us. Generally speaking, we're pretty slow on the uptake. And you know, we don't have a lot of experience having our heart pointed toward God and suffering and repenting. Big scenarios with lots of tears and rolling around in the ashes on the ground, not really part of most of our experience. Mostly our material needs are met. Few of us go to bed hungry or worried about where we're going to get our next meal tomorrow. We're safe and happy and we're warm, or it's so warm that we have air conditioner running. I wonder, do we still know how to repent? The prophet here addresses Judah. He says, dress in sackcloth. The question, if you were in their shoes, would you do that? Would you humiliate yourself? Would you roll on the ground in the dirt and humiliate yourself? Some of us might say, no, that's a step too far. It's too emotional. It's too undignified. It's not in vogue. It won't look good on Instagram. Now, I don't suppose our outward manifestation of repentance today has to be just exactly like we see in the time of the kingdom of Judah back here in the BC years. But in what way would we be repentant? Well, how would we manifest it? How much do we desire God? That's a question. How strongly do you desire him to be right with him, to be in his kingdom, to be an agent of his work? How strongly do you want it? Do you and I want Jesus all the way to tears? Are we willing to cry for it? Are we willing to be embarrassed for the kingdom? Or are we going to fold when somebody calls us a name? Some things to give thought to as we're seeking to serve the Lord. Let's pray together. Dear Father in heaven, help our hearts to be right. Help us to be willing to follow you at any and all costs. You may not require it of us. We may not have to sell all that we have and give it to the poor. We may not need to roll in the ashes on the ground. But Lord, whatever we do need to do, help us to know what it is. And then Lord, please give us a heart to do it. Help us to draw close to you in these dark years of strong secularization. Please help your church, Lord, and we ask for this in Jesus' name. Amen. So may he help us to know how we've departed from him and how we can return. God be with you today.